I think that first of all, we have to be honest with ourselves that a lot of math has crept in for purposes of intimidation, to make cryptic, which is otherwise simple, and to create a kind of interference competition where the field could be restricted to a smaller number of players. So I think that there's a tremendous amount of abuse of mathematics, and I think that that's probably the right way for the INET energy to be funneled towards the abuse. But unfortunately, it ends up too often funneled towards the mathematics itself, where people have been brutalized by an instrument that, in fact, is not biased good or bad. And I think one place where you can see a difference is by asking that there be some sort of prose explanation for why a particular piece of mathematics needs to be introduced. So, off the top of my head, one of the things that bothers me most is that economists have all sorts of data typing problems. We call things by scalars that are actually fields. No one would accept the idea that the temperature in America yesterday was 70 degrees, because we know we have Alaska, Hawaii, Florida, and Maine, which are all likely to have different temperatures. But too often, we're willing to say the rate of inflation is X, or you know, growth was Y in some particular quarter. So one of the problems is that you're feeding the wrong data types back into the models. This means you can't make use of the field concept, which is used to regulate other self-regulating systems, as it is, let's say, in theoretical and particle physics. So one candidate would be, why is it that we've accepted that these models are prejudiced from inception to deliver certain kinds of conclusions? Having a single scalar for inflation or growth obviously means that the gauge is susceptible to fiddling. But if you try to fiddle with an entire field, that is a field concept, it's almost impossible. So I would love to see more autonomous mathematics that is not quite so amenable to special pleading from powerful interests.